إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تبارك وتعالى عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا نحن نزلنا الذكر وإنا له لحافظون وقال تبارك وتعالى لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله وقال تبارك وتعالى أفلا يتدبرون القرآن ولو كان من عند غير الله لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام Respected ulama ikram, elders, brothers and sisters, Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us a golden opportunity to attend this auspicious and blessed gathering. A gathering full of blessing and full of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's favors that Sayyiduna Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiyallahu ta'ala anhu mentions and Sayyiduna Abu Hurairah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu mention a hadith that a gathering which is held for the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the gathering where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's name is going to be mentioned where the talk of deen will be mentioned Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends his tranquility and peace upon that gathering And the angels surround this kind of gathering. To this extent, at the end of the hadith, he says that all the people who gather in that gathering, it is said that قُومُ مَغْفُورًا لَكُمْ That all of you stand up, all your sins have been forgiven. Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this opportunity to attend this kind of gathering today. As Muslims, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us so many responsibilities. In the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the objective, the reason of creation of mankind. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ That I have not created jinn and human beings, but that they may worship me. Man's task And his obligation is that he worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To do this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the time of Adam alayhi salatu was salam till our last beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he sent many prophets and messengers to propagate and convey this message. And conveying this message was not an easy task. If we look at the lives of the Anbiya Kiram, the prophets and the messengers. Sayyiduna Nuh alayhi salatu was salam, he propagated deen for over 950 years. And he put this message forward, أَنِعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَهٍ غَيْرُ That worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no God but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For 950 years, he propagated this message. To this extent, he says, that inni a'lamtu lahum asrartu lahum israra day and night publicly privately he continued to spread this message and what does the holy quran say wama amana ma'ahu illa qalil only a handful of people accepted the mufassirun they mentioned only about 80 people in that span of time 950 years only approximately 80 people accepted the religion and accepted Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam as the prophet. So you can imagine that all the prophets, they went through this hardship. And many times Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave miracles to the different prophet to help and aid and assist the prophets and the messengers to propagate this message. Sayyiduna Salih alayhi salatu wasalam, when the people rejected his call, he was given a miracle. A she-camel was brought out from a stone, from a rock. And this miracle was shown, but only a handful of people accepted. Sayyiduna Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, he was put into the fire. And what happened? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed this miracle, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the fire, قُلْنَا يَا نَارُ كُونِي بَرْضًا وَسَلَامًا عَلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمٍ, that this same fire, which the feature is to burn, but for Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, this fire became a coolness and peace and safety for him. In this same way, miracles were given to different prophets. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he was given the staff which transformed into a snake. And we know the incident where he challenged the 70,000 magicians, that his staff, it transformed into a snake and he swallowed every single of the stick and the staff which was made by the magician into snakes. So basically, Allama Ibn Kathir rahimahullah ta'ala, he says that in every era, according to the society of that time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent miracles to the Prophet according to that time. Sayyiduna Isa alayhi salatu wasalam time, Tib, science, was prevalent. It was on the highest peak. And at that time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the miracle with Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, that he could cure the lepers and the ones who were born blind. He himself says that إِنِّي أَخْلُقُ لَكُم مِّنَ الطِّيرِ كَهَيْئَةِ الطَّيْرِ بِإِذْنِي فَتَنْفُخُ فِيهَا فَتَكُونُ طَيْرًا بِإِذْنِي وَأُبْرِئُ الْأَكْمَهَ وَالْأَبْرَصَ وَأُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى بِإِذْنِي, that I could cure the people who were born blind and I could cure those people who are lepers. So in the same way, at the time of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, at that time poetry, eloquence, this was rife in the community. To this extent, in the Arab land, a small child, a shepherd, could read couplets, ash'ar, poetry, hundreds of them simultaneously without any problem. At that time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent this miracle of the Holy Quran, challenging mankind. That when this Holy Quran was put forward by the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to the polytheist of Mecca, and the challenge was put forward to every single man, that قُلْ لَإِنِ اجْتَمَعَتِ الْإِنْسُ وَالْجِنُ عَلَىٰ أَن يَأْتُوا بِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ, that say to these people, the human beings and the jinn, that all of you gather together and try to produce something like that of the Holy Quran. What does the Holy Quran say? La ya'tuna bimithlihi. They will not be able to bring something similar to the Holy Quran. Walau kana ba'duhum li ba'din dhahira. Even though they all gather together. When this challenge was put forward, no one could challenge that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in another verse makes this challenge even more easier. He says, Am yaquluna iftara. Do they say regarding this Holy Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that he has sent, that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he has forged that Holy Quran. Say to them, Fa'atu bi ashri suwarim mithlihi muftarayat. So try to make 10 surahs like that of the Holy Quran. Wad'u man istata'tum min dunillah. And call all those people that you can to help you other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in kuntum sadiqeen, if you are truthful. But they could not do that. In the end, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put another challenge forward. He said, wa in kuntum fi raibin mimma nazzalna ala abdina fa'tu bi suratin min mithli. That if you are in doubt regarding what we have revealed to our servant, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then fa'tu bi suratin min mithli. Then bring only one surah like that of the Holy Quran. Bring a surah the size of Suratul Asr or Suratul Kawthar. But what does the Quran say? فَإِنْ لَمْ تَفَعَلُوا وَلَمْ تَفَعَلُوا فَاتَّقُوا النَّارُ الَّتِي وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ الْحِجَارَةِ. That if you can't, and the Holy Quran is saying, you'll never be able to do that. That فَإِنْ لَمْ تَفَعَلُوا وَلَمْ تَفَعَلُوا, you'll never be able to do that. فَاتَّقُوا النَّارُ الَّتِي وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ الْحِجَارَةِ. So fear the fire. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put that challenge. All the miracles that were sent to the other prophets, they finished with the prophet departing from the earth. But the Holy Quran was a miracle in the past. It's a miracle in the present time, and it will be a miracle till the day of judgment. Because the challenge is still there. Until today, until day of judgment, no one has or no one will be able to bring something similar to the Holy Quran. So this Holy Quran Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, and He has taken the responsibility of preserving the Holy Quran. Inna nahnu nazzalna dhikra wa inna lahu lahafidhun. Indeed, we have revealed the Holy Quran, the reminder, wa inna lahu lahafidhun. And indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we will safeguard the Holy Quran, we will preserve the Holy Quran. This Holy Quran, subhanallah, if you look at the lives of pious predecessors, how much they acted upon the Holy Quran. And today, how neglectful we are with the Holy Quran. The topic, the relationship, our relationship to the Holy Quran. What is our relationship? And what did the relationship, what was the relationship of the people prior to us, our pious predecessors, our elders, how they actually had the connection with the Holy Quran. Sayyiduna Abdullah ibn Mubarak rahimullah ta'ala, one of the great eminent student of Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah ta'ala, he says that once when I was coming back from Hajj, on the way I met this woman and I saw her sitting isolated, and I knew that she was lost. So I approached her. And the reason I'm going to mention this incident is to explain to you how much these people had connection of the Holy Quran. That Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mubarak rahimahullah ta'ala says that I asked this woman, I said salam to her, and then I asked her few questions. And every answer that she gave was from the Holy Quran. So Abdullah ibn Mubarak rahimahullah ta'ala says, assalamu alaikum. The woman replies, salamun qawlam min rabbir rahim. A verse of Surah Yasin, the salam, word of peace from the Lord who is the most merciful. Then Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mubarak rahimahullah ta'ala says, what's happened? Why are you here for? The woman replies, man yudlilillahu fala hadiyala. That whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala misguides, there is no one to guide. So she was referring that I am lost here. So Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mubarak rahimahullah ta'ala says, where are you going at this moment of time? So she reads this verse, Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi laylan min al-masjid al-haram ila al-masjid al-aqsa. That she had just finished her hajj and she is now visiting Baytul Maqdis. So she reads this verse, which means glory to be that being who has taken his servant in the night journey from Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa. Then Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mubarak rahimahullah ta'ala says that how long have you been in this place? So she replies, Thalatha layalin sawiyya. That I've been here for 3 complete nights. So what about your food? So she replies, Huwa yut'imuni wa yasqeen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that being who gives me food and he gives me drink. So he asks that, how have you been doing your ablution, your wudu, for praying your namaz? So she goes, فَلَمْ تَجِدُوا مَاءً فَتَيَمَّمُوا صَعِيدًا طَيِّبًا. That if you don't find water, then do tayammum with clean earth. So after that, Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mubarak rahimahullah ta'ala says that I got some food with me, so do you want some food? So she replies, ثُمَّ أَتِمُّ الصِّيَامَ إِلَى اللَّيْلِ. That complete your fast till the night time. In other words, she was saying that I am fasting. So Abdullah ibn Mubarak rahimahullah ta'ala astonished that you're fasting, you're traveling as well. It's not the month of Ramadan. So why are you fasting for? So she says, وَمَن تَتَوَّى خَيْرًا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ شَاكِرٌ عَلِيمٌ. The person who does optional thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appreciates that and he knows that. Then she goes that, Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mubarak rahimahullah ta'ala asks that you are traveling, so there's no need for you to fast, even optional. Fast, there's no need for it. So she reads, وَأَنْتَسُومُوا خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. That if you know about fasting, that is better for you, then you would surely fast. Then afterwards, Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mubarak rahmatullah alayhi says that will you are lost here, so I will try to find your belongings. I will try to find the people. So will you come with me? So she says, وَمَا تَفَعَلُوا مِنْ خَيْرٍ يَعْلَمُهُ اللَّهِ. That whatever good you do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows about it. In other words, I am happy for that. So he puts the camel forward and tells her to mount on the camel. So at that moment, the woman says, قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُدُّوا مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ. That say to the believing men to lower the gaze. So Sayyidina Abdullah Mubarak rahmatullahi alayhi, he lowers his gaze. The woman just about to go on the camel, to mount on the camel, then a part of a cloth got stuck. So she says, مَا أَصَابَكُم مِّن مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ. Whatever musibah, whatever hardship comes, it is because of our own deeds. Then Sayyidina Abdullah Mubarak rahmatullahi ta'ala, he ties the camel properly and she gets onto the camel. When she mounts onto the camel, she says, Subhanalladhi sakhara lana hadha wa ma kunna lahu muqrinin wa inna ila rabbina lamunqalibun. She reads the dua which we read when we actually sit in the vehicle or transport. So she reads that and she gets onto the camel, and Sayyidina Abdullah Mubarak rahmatullahi ta'ala, he actually takes the reins and he's taking her forward towards the caravan which she has been severed from, or she got lost. So they keep on going. At that moment of time, Sayyidina Abdullah Mubarak rahmatullahi is inquisitive. He asks that, and which tribe are you from? Which clan are you from? Which part of the country are you from? So she says, وَلَا تَقْفُ مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٍ. That do not go behind those things that you have no knowledge regarding. So Sayyidina Abdullah Mubarak rahmatullah alayhi keeps quiet. And at that moment of time, he thought to himself that I will read some poetry. So he's reading some poetry. At that time, the woman says that, فَقْرَأُوا مَا تَيَسَّرَ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ. Read something from the Holy Quran. So she starts to read something from the Holy Quran, and the woman says, وَمَا يَذَّكَّرُ إِلَّا أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. That mashallah, you've understood what I am trying to say, and only those people who are intelligent, they actually get admonition from this. Because the camel was going fast and he was reading loudly, so the woman said, وَقْصِدْ فِي مَشِّكَ وَقْدُدْ مِنْ سَوْتِكَ. That be moderate in your pace and lower your voice. So Sayyidina Abdullah Mubarak rahmatullahi alayhi takes her forward, and at that time they are just about to reach and the place. Sayyidina Abdullah Mubarak rahmatullahi alayhi asks that, are you married? Have you got a husband? So at that moment she says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu la tas'alu an ashiya'a in tubdalakum tasu'ukum. That all you who believe, do not ask regarding those things. If that becomes apparent to you, you will dislike it. So at that moment, Sayyidina Abdullah Mubarak rahmatullahi alayhi asks forgiveness. The woman says, La tathriba alaykum al-yawm. There is no blame for you today. Yaghfirullahu lakum, Allah will forgive you. So they reach a caravan. At that moment, Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mubarak rahmatullahi alayhi asks the woman, Have you got any people that you know here? So she replies, Al malu wal banuna zinatul hayatid dunya. That I have my wealthy and I have my children here. So Sayyidina Abdullah Mubarak rahmatullahi alayhi asks that, what is the duty of your children here? So she says, wa alamat wa bin najmihum yahtadun. That the signs and with the star they be guided. In other words, they are the guide of this caravan. So at that moment, when the woman and Sayyidina Abdullah Mubarak rahmatullahi alayhi get close to the caravan, the woman, she calls the children that, وَاتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهُ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا يَا يَحْيَا قُذِ الْكِتَابَ بِقُوَّةِ. In other words, she got three sons there. One Musa, the second Ibrahim, and the third Yahya. So three children, they come running out, and when they see the mother, they get very happy. At that moment of time, the mother says that, فَبْعَثُوا أَحَدَكُمْ بِوَرِقِكُمْ هَذِهِ إِلَى الْمَدِينَةِ فَلْيَنْظُرْ أَيُّهَا أَزْكَى طُعَامًا فَلْيَأْتِكُمْ بِرِزْقٍ مِّنْهُ. That send one of you and take this money and get some food, get some halal sustenance, because this person has done a favor for us. So when the food comes, she says, Subhanallah, kulu washrabu hani'an bima aslaftum fil ayyamil khaliya. Eat and drink because of what the goodness that you've done in the past. And then she reads, hal jaza'ul ihsani illa al ihsan. For the goodness is only goodness. Sayyidina Abdullah Mubarak rahmatullah alayhi, amazed and shocked at the words and the verses that she has recited, that every single answer she gave was from the Holy Quran. He says to the children, this food is haram for me until you don't tell me who this woman is. So the children say, this is our mother. And for 40 years, she has not spoken but the Holy Quran. 40 years, she has been speaking only the Holy Quran, only for this reason, that she does not want to say anything which will become a problem for her on the Day of Judgment. Because مَا يَلْفِذُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ. Every word that we utter, there is an observer here who is observing every single thing. كِرَامًا كَاتِبِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ مَا تَفْعَلُونَ. The kiram and katimin, they know every single thing that we do. So subhanAllah, the reason I mentioned this incident is how much connection these people had with the Holy Quran. And subhanAllah, if we look at the lives of our pious predecessors, this is how they had the connection. Because of having that connection with the Holy Quran, they were successful. Today, what happens is, in the month of Ramadan, we might recite the Holy Quran. When somebody passes away, we might recite Surah Yasin, or we might do a khatam, that's it. We have put the Holy Quran for these special occasions. But our pious predecessors, subhanAllah, how did they act upon the Holy Quran? Mus'ab ibn Kharija rahimullah ta'ala, he says, there are four people that he knows, he says, that they finished the Holy Quran in one rakat. In one single rakat, they finished the Holy Quran, and he mentions the name of Sayyidina Uthman Ghani radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. That once what happened was that he came near Maqam Ibrahim in front of the Kaaba, and he stood there and he started his tahajjud after Isha Salah. And in his first rakat from Surah Al-Fatiha until Qul A'udhu Birabbin Nas, he read the full Quran, and after finishing the Quran, he went into ruku. This was the love and the devotion the Sahaba Ikram had for the Holy Quran. Sayyiduna Tamim Dari radiallahu ta'ala, he used to also finish the Holy Quran in one rakat. Sayyiduna Sayyid ibn Jubair radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he mentions about him that he used to finish the Holy Quran in one rakat. Sayyiduna Imam Abu Hanifa rahimullahu ta'ala says regarding him that he used to finish the Holy Quran in one rakat. The love they had for this Holy Quran, subhanAllah, is so amazing. And not only reciting the Holy Quran, we recite the Holy Quran, we know the virtues of the Holy Quran, it is a responsibility for us that we act upon the Holy Quran as well. The Holy Quran has not just come as something that we read only in the month of Ramadan or special occasions. It has come as a guidance. ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِي هُدَلْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. This kitab, there is no doubt in it. هُدَلْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. It is a guidance for those people who are pious. So we need to put that into practice. Or else what's going to happen, like the hadith mentions, Al-Qur'an hujjatul laka wa alayk. The Qur'an can be an evidence for us or can be an evidence against us. If we act upon the Holy Qur'an, if we practice upon the Holy Qur'an, then this Holy Qur'an will intercede for us. And if we neglect the Holy Qur'an, if we do not recite the Holy Qur'an, if we put that to a side, like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Qur'an, that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّقَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا. That these people have completely neglected and forsaken the Holy Qur'an. We don't want on the Day of Judgment the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam becoming against us because we have neglected the Holy Qur'an. We don't want the Holy Qur'an going against us because we have neglected the Holy Qur'an. We need to put that into practice and we need to recite it. The first responsibility of the Holy Quran, the first obligation that we have is that we recite the Holy Quran. In the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Utlu ma uhi ilayka min al-kitabi wa aqimis salah. Recite what has been revealed to you, wa aqimis salah, and establish prayer. So the first responsibility is that we recite the Holy Quran. Sayyiduna Abdullah ibn Masud radiyallahu ta'ala says, the hadith has been narrated by Imam Tirmidhi rahimullah ta'ala, he says that every letter that we recite, a person gets 10 reward for that. Then he says that Alif Lam Mim is not one letter, but Alif is one letter, Lam is another letter, Mim is another letter. Thus a person by reciting Alif Lam Mim, he gets 30 rewards for that. So every letter that we recite, and the reason he mentioned Alif Lam Mim, because we don't know the meaning of Alif Lam Mim. Nowadays there is this conception that we think if you don't understand something, you don't recite it, you don't read it. That's completely wrong. This hadith completely elaborates and clarifies this matter, that either we understand the Holy Quran, we don't understand the Holy Quran, we'll get reward for that. And second thing, we need to ponder and understand the Holy Quran. هذا كتاب أنزلناه مبارك ليتدبروا آياته وليتذكر أولو الألباب. This kitab has been revealed that we ponder over the Holy Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala invites us to understand the Holy Quran. أفلا يتدبرون القرآن. Do you not ponder over the Holy Quran? Do you not contemplate and think about the Holy Quran? Because ولو كان من عند غير الله, if this Holy Quran was from any other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you would have surely found mistakes and contradiction in that Holy Quran. But this Holy Quran, as I mentioned earlier, there's no doubt in the Holy Quran, there's no contradiction in the Holy Quran, it has been revealed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا يأتيه الباطل من بين يديه ولا من خلفه تنزيل من حكيم حميد. It is revealed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So second duty is that we understand the Holy Quran. And third is that we follow and we practice upon the Holy Quran. وَهَذَا كِتَابٌ أَنْزَلْنَاهُ وَرَكُنْ آيَاتِ فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَاتَّقُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. That we follow the Holy Quran and we understand the Holy Quran, and we, by following the Holy Quran, only then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ, that you can be shown mercy upon yourself. That by following and understanding and practicing upon the Holy Quran. Nowadays, one big problem we have, we say that we don't have the time. We're so busy with so many things. We've heard the name of this pious person called Qutub Bakhtiyar Kaki Rahimullah Ta'ala. Qutubuddin Bakhtiyar Kaki Rahmatullah Alayh. This pious person, when he passed away, what happened was, there were thousands of people in his janazah, in his funeral. Seas of people that the eyes could see, that there was thousands of people in his janazah. And they were waiting for the janazah to take place, when suddenly a person came forward and he said that Sheikh has left a will behind, and he has said that this person will lead the janazah of mine who has these four qualities in that person. So everybody silent, waiting to find out what are these four qualities of the person who can lead the janazah. So he mentioned that these four qualities, number one, that this person who's going to lead the janazah has to be that person that who has never missed a salah with takbira ula. That this person has always, after the age of maturity, that he has read every single namaz with takbira ula, with the first takbir with the imam. That's the first condition. Second one, he says that this person, he has never missed his tahajjud salah. Second condition is that this person has never missed his tahajjud salah. And the third condition is that this person has never looked at a strange woman. Those things which are not permissible for him. And the fourth condition, which is the hardest of all, I think, is that this person has never missed the four rakat of sunnatul asr. Not the faraz, the sunnat of asr namaz, which is a ghair mu'akkada, which is not an emphasized sunnah. So that this person has not missed the four rakats, which is before the faraz of asr namaz. So if these four qualities are found in any person in this gathering, then he should come forward and lead the janazah salah. Just imagine, if I ask the same question here, is there any person who will have these qualities or one of these qualities? So completely silence. Complete silence in the gathering, thousands of people, all his disciples, students, all the mashayikh, all the ulama, all the scholars, all the pious people there, nobody was coming forward. Then suddenly one person comes forward, tears in his eyes, and he says that, Wallah, Sheikh, you have passed away, but you have completely disgraced me. I kept this secret between Allah and myself. I didn't want anybody to know these qualities that I have. But today, I make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala my witness, and all these people my witness. Alhamdulillah, I have these four qualities in me. And this person comes forward and he leads the janazah salah. Who was this person? History testifies that this person was the king of that time, Shamsuddin Al-Tamish rahimahullah ta'ala. The king of the time. The reason I'm saying that is that nowadays we make this excuse that we don't have time for anything. This person, he was leading a country. He was in charge, responsible of a full country, and this person had the time to do these things. He had the time to perform his salah with takbir awla. He had the time to perform tahajjud. He had the time to perform those sunnahs which were not even emphasized as well. He stayed away from sins. So who are we to say we don't have the time to fulfill these obligations, to fulfill the sunnahs of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to have the time to recite the Holy Quran? So it is our responsibility that we take the time out, because the time is not going to wait for anybody. Time is very precious and we need to utilize it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes the oath in time, wala asr innal insana lafi khusr, that by the token of time all mankind is in destruction. Why? Because he is wasting that time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this time, this precious thing. Ightanim khamsan qabla khams. Beautiful hadith, he says, cherish five things before five things. Value five things before five things. What are these things? Shababaka qabla haramik. All our youngsters, we should value our youth before our old age. When we become old, we will not be able to do the good deeds that we can do now. Wasihataka qabla saqamik. That our health before our sickness. When we are healthy, we can do those good deeds that we can't do when we are ill. وَفَرَاغَكَ قَبْلَ شُغْلِكَ, our free time before our occupation. When we have free time, we should utilize that. Nowadays, we say we can't spend this time, we can't kill our time. We've got so much time on our hands, we are bored. As a Muslim, there's no such thing as killing time, there's no such thing as boredom. So a person should utilize his free time before he gets occupied. وَغِنَاكَ قَبْلَ فَقْرِكَ, his wealth, his prosperity before his poverty. Allah's given us wealth, we should spend it in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the last thing the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, wa hayataka qabla mawtik, and your life before your death. So we need to think very carefully, what direction is our life going to? Are we going towards the path which the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has directed, our pious predecessors have directed, or are we going towards the wrong path? So it is very important that we keep that in mind. And the relationship with the Holy Quran, when we build that relationship, then subhanallah, we will see that we will be prosperous in this life and we will be prosperous and we will be successful in the hereafter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the true understanding of deen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to act upon what has been said. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.